Looking for an added challenge to just going fishing? Then check out any number of the 24 remote ponds that are stocked by New Hampshire Fish and Game. Trails into these ponds vary in difficulty. Anglers that hike into these remote ponds should know the hiker's code.
So here at Greeley Pond, from the parking lot up, took us a little more than an hour, but we took our time. I mean, we're carrying a lot of stuff with us, so.
Yeah, I would like to weigh that and see what that's like so that we can have some idea about, you know, when we talk about this with other folks, because obviously this is going to be something that, you know, we want to share with people about how much, you know, how much gear we brought, how much it weighed, and then how long it took us. And it would give people a good perspective about what their limitations are, and so that they'll actually come and do that here too and be able to share this really beautiful spot.
The one thing that I remember from being a kid is what got me the freedom to go out and do all these adventurous things is I always left a note.
Note is the best thing to do.
You know, it's simple. Where I'm going, time I expect to be back, and don't deviate from it.
And don't ever deviate from it.
So what I do know with flow tubing is you look out where you're going, because that's when you're coming back, so you need some sort of landmark to remember where you were.
Exactly.
Because I'm going to go in backwards and I'm just going to see the shoreline. When I come back, I'm going backwards and I'm not going to see the shoreline.
So you want to have a point of reference when you go in.
180 degrees out.
This is why I bought one that you can just sit your bottom down in, because this can be a little bit of a challenge.
Well, you can feel that water temperature change there.
Oh, that is a little chilly, isn't it?
A little bit.
Well deserving for that hike.
This is a tough way to spend a day in the mountain.
Yeah, I know. And look at it. It is. It's beautiful. Well worth the hike, I will say. All right, let's see what we got going. See if these guys like this over here.
He's here somewhere waiting for my golden retriever.
It's actually really nice temperature. I have shorts on under my waders, and I'm not too cold, but I'm not too warm. Gosh, it's so beautiful.
And I can see a big tree right underneath me here, too. It's probably in 15 feet of water.
And there's perfect structure in here. There's another little rise.
Put a big puppy fly on there.
I put a royal wolf on.
Pop it like a popper.
Yeah, I'm just going to space
bloop,
out on it.
Bloop.
They've been every once in a while, they'll come up. So I'm wondering if it just stays kind of flat here, I could get one to come up. Ooh, I slapped it. Ooh, fish on! That was awesome. And you know, the fish is the same size as the stinking fly. Oh my God, it was a riot. Come here, little one. I'll save you from the royal wolf.
Ooh. That one's got a little meat to it. I went with the stimulator. Oh yeah, that's a treasure right there.
I sunk it and he shot right at it. Oh, this is a giant one.
Look at this thing in the sun.
Yeah, beautiful speckles on him.
See you later, buddy.
Really, how can you hate that? It's entertaining.
Oh, look at this right here. Big mayfly. Gray one.
There you go. It's a good story to tell too. A wonderful